After having some introduction to geometry that we are going to use, let us start this chapter. So this chapter is concerned mainly about electromagnetic radiation between these 400 nanometer to 750 nanometer, and this radiation is called light. So why we are studying this particular radiation? Because human eye is sensitive to this radiation. So this is called visible radiation or visible light. And as we have known that speed of light is very high, and we write this 3 into 10 to power 8 meter per second. So this travels with very high speeds. Now in chapter 8 we have learned that light is nothing but an electromagnetic wave. So there is an electromagnetic component, that means one electric component and one magnetic component, and both are perpendicular to each other. So if this electric component is in y axis, this must be in z axis, and wave must be traveling in x axis. That we have learned. But why we are taking this approximation that light is a ray? Why we are considering this light to be a ray? The reason is that the size of daily object, our daily life objects, is very large. So we know the wavelength of light, lambda, is equal to 400 nanometer to 750 nanometer. So this is of order of 1 micron or 10 to power minus 6 meter. 10 to power minus 6 meter. This is order. This is order. And this size of ordinary objects that we see in daily life, that is generally in few centimeters or larger than that. So again, size of daily objects A, I am writing this A. So this is generally 10 to power minus 2 meter. So in this case we can say A is around 10 to the power 4 times, 10 to power 4 times larger than this wavelength of light. That's why we can say that this ray approximation or light travels in straight line is a good approximation. That's why we consider that light travels in straight line. But if we go to very small objects, then this approximation is not correct. That we will learn later what is the problem with this approximation then. But for the time being, for understanding this chapter, where objects are in centimeter, that means in 10 to the power 2 meter or larger than that, then this approximation, where wavelength of light is very less, this approximation is quite correct. So we are going to treat light as a ray. That means light travels in straight line joining between two points, and this path is called ray of light. So if we join these two points, this path is called ray of light. And if we have many such rays, then we call them beam of light. So what is a ray? So ray has one source, some source of light, and it travels in a straight line joining between these two points, straight line, and this line is called ray of light. So in this chapter, what we are going to study? We are going to study reflection, refraction and dispersion of light, but using the ray picture. In the next chapter we will study same phenomena but using the wave picture. But here we are considering that light travels in straight direction, and since the objects are much bigger than the wavelength of light, so we can consider this as a ray of light. Now apart from that, we will learn about some optical instruments and human eye. So this is we are going to study. So there are few models regarding this ray optics and or optics. So one is that ray optics, another is the wave optics that we learn in next chapter. And there was a model, particle model of light. So Newton studied this nature of light. He considered light to be a particle. What he thought, that light is not a wave, but light are tiny particles. Light is made of tiny particles. So learn more about this, because I am leaving it to you to learn about, because this is very simple, that how he defined light in terms of particle. So this is called particle model of light. Now let us come to main topics of this chapter. This main topics are reflection of light by spherical mirrors. So first let us go back to our basics. What is reflection by a plane mirror? Reflection by a plane mirror. So if we have a plane mirror, first of all there must be a normal to this plane mirror. So there is a normal to the plane of this mirror. If light is incident at some angle theta with this normal, then this light must reflect at the same angle theta, and we have already learned that incident angle must be equal to the angle of reflected ray. If this is theta, this must be theta. If this is phi, this must also be phi. Now if we put this mirror in this way, then normal is in this way. Again, if this angle is theta, then light must reflect at theta angle. This angle must also be theta. So these are some of the fundamentals that we need to revise before starting this chapter. This was for a flat mirror. Finding normal for a flat mirror is quite easy. So this is, if this is a normal, if this angle is theta, then reflected angle is also theta. But what will happen? What will happen if instead of this flat mirror, we take a spherical mirror? So spherical mirror can be of two types. So we must learn this convention. So this can be of two types. So first of all, if this is the reflecting side, this is the reflecting side of the mirror, and this is the non-reflecting side. So this is the way to show the mirrors. The non-reflecting side is shown like this, and this reflecting side is plane. So this is a spherical mirror, and this one is concave mirror. This one is concave mirror, concave. The another type of mirror, again this is also a spherical mirror, but in this mirror this side is reflecting and this side is non-reflecting. So we always show non-reflecting sides by these lines. So this side is reflecting side, so ray is coming on this, and this side is reflecting side, and this is called convex mirror. Convex mirror. And you can relate both of them with this. If you have this type of lens, we call it concave lens. Concave lens. And if we have this type of lens, so we call it a convex lens. Convex lens. Similarly, similar to lenses, this is called convex mirror, this is called concave mirror. In concave mirror, this side is reflecting, that means light will fall on it and will get reflect. And in convex mirror, this side is reflecting and this side is non-reflecting. So there is a difference. So if we want to make this mirror, if we complete this mirror like a circle, so center is somewhere here. Center is somewhere here. For this mirror, center is somewhere here. So that is difference. So that is the difference between a concave mirror and a convex mirror. For a concave mirror, center lies inside this circle, reflecting circle. But if we take this convex mirror, so center lies in the non-reflecting side, non-reflecting circle. So that is the difference. Now, what about this law of reflection? So what happens? So we know this is law of reflection. This incident and reflected ray must make same angle with the normal. What happens in case of a spherical mirror? So this phenomena is valid, also valid for spherical mirrors. This phenomena is valid for spherical mirrors, but the way to draw normal will change. So we are taking only example of this concave mirror. So this is our concave mirror. So if we are having these three lines, 1, 2, 3, and this is a beam of parallel line, parallel beam. This is the parallel light beam. So now how will these rays reflect? First of all, we have to find what is the normal. So how can we find normal? We simply put a tangent at this point, and normal to this tangent is called the normal. At this point, this tangent is like in this direction, normal is in this direction. At this point, tangent is in this direction, normal is in this direction. So now this is the angle, so beam must reflect in this fashion. Now here, since incident angle and reflecting angle must be equal, both must be zero, so beam will reflect in this angle. Here this angle is, let us say, phi, so this must be reflected at this angle phi. So all these angles must be equal, but the way how we draw normal, that will change.